Governor Ortom escaped death as Fulani herdsmen opened fire on his convoy. Hear the news in details. Wonderful people of Biafra, lovers of freedom all over the world, you are welcome once again to Biafra Unite Channel / Television this very wonderful moment. The disturbing news reaching our news desk this very moment has it that Governor Ortom of Benue State has escaped death as Fulani herdsmen opened fire on his convoy along Makodi Boko Express Highway. Wow, this is happening in Nigeria, and I can assure you authoritatively that Nigeria is finished. Nigeria is gone and gone forever, because how can you tell me on a daily basis there's this kind of insecurity growing and growing wings in a country that claim they have president, in a country that claim they have army, in a country that claim they have police, air force, defense force, whatever they call it, navy and civil defense, and other security operatives. In a country that claim they have all these things, spending billions of money, millions of dollars every year buying and, or should I say, purchasing ammunition from Western world. And this kind of insecurity is rearing its ugly head in the same country. I can assure you this, what is happening right now is just taking Nigeria to disintegration. That's all. There's nothing anybody can do with. And, we can say that, it's favoring us. Yes, it's favoring us, because God Elohim told, Pharaoh, let my people go. Pharaoh refused until God visited Egypt. With so many plague. Yes, God visited Egypt with so many plague, different types, but he never shake Pharaoh until the day God killed every first son in Egypt, including the one of Pharaoh. That is the day he knew, yes, these people must go now. And that is what is happening in Nigeria. Have you seen what is going on? Can you tell me that what is happening in Nigeria today is not exactly what happened in the Bible? Which other country can you tell me, unless it's a country on a civil war, total blown, full blown war? Apart from that, tell me any country that suffered this kind of insecurity. If that country is not in a full-blown war that is being announced, and the United Nations, everybody knows that this country is fighting. Just like Libya and Somalia and other places. There is no any peace, any country that claim is peaceful. There is no any peaceful country in this worldwide, in this wide world, that is suffering this kind of insecurity we have in Nigeria today. No one. It's only in the zoo. It's only happening in the zoo because they are holding down the children of Elohim, the children of Almighty God, those who their names are being named after God, those who answer the name of God. They are holding them down in an almighty zoo called Nigeria. You can't hold them down. You can just do, they have done their own part. The Nigerian government, in conjunction with the British government, have done their part since 1914 to 2014. You can't continue holding us down. Now we are free people, we should live on our own. And the earlier Nigerian government to understand it, the better for them. Have you seen it? ESN moved to Lower Benue. You know, to rescue our people, the Igbo communities in Benue State, who are suffering the same thing we are suffering here in Biafra land, the same thing we are suffering every other places, in the hands of Fulani herdsmen terrorists. Then when ESN moved in there, one idiot that claimed to be local government chairman began to run his mouth. You know, the worst aspect of it is that the idiot also is coming from the same community where ESN has gone to restore peace and normalcy in the land. The idiot is coming from that same community. What a shame. Have you seen that, you know, our people, I don't know what they did to them with Nigeria constitution. Once you have any political, office, you are gone and gone forever. You can never ever return back to your people again. You are gone. Your brain, your mentality, your ID, everything is gone. Everything is being taken away from you by Fulani. Have you seen it? So I came across one write up on Facebook. Somebody urging the Biafrans to, you know, to use their legislators to, you know, to pass bail for Biafra in the house. I look at them, I laugh. I say, these are fools, bonkons, you know, some useless elements, some idiotic individuals who cannot even read the handwriting on the wall. They are just coming to social media to write garbage. Very, very useless and animalistic. Idiotic indeed. Hey, how can you expect this kind of politicians we have in Biafra land to listen to you? To hear anything concerning the breakup of Nigeria, where they are eating the crops from the tables of the master. You want them to listen? That you will be hallucinating. You are just making fool of yourself. For you to think that the politicians, these ones we have. So somebody like Hope Uzodinma now, who without any offense, invited Fulani Janjaweed from Fota Jalon to come and wipe our people in Olu. Is that such a person will listen to you to go and, you know, to negotiate with Nigeria government for the breakup of Nigeria? Is this somebody like Nweke, Nyeso Nweke, will listen to you, who brought Fulani Janjaweed army all the way from Fota Jalon to Obi Igbo to massacre our own people, our flesh and blood, our Igbo brethren in Obi Igbo? Is that somebody who can listen to you seriously? Are you telling me that somebody like Rochas Okorawusa, when his own blood have been massacred in Olu, he's busy fighting for hotel with Uzodinma in Owerri? And now tell me, who is going to fight for you? Who is that person that will fight for you? Who? I want to ask you, who will fight for you? Rochas Okorawusa is a senator. Is he the one that will fight for you? How? What are people that have sworn an oath to protect the integrity of the zoo, the Almighty Zoological Republic of Niger area? People that have sworn allegiance to the constitution, the useless paper, the useless sheet of paper you call constitution. Actually, let me tell you, that very constitution is respected only in the southern part of the country. For you to, if you don't know, let me tell you right now. That very paper you call constitution is only respected in the southern part of Nigeria. In the south, both Oduduwa land and Biafra land are the only places you can see people respecting that very useless paper you call constitution. Because that is the place our governors here now in Biafra land, including Oduduwa, is the only place you could see a governor trying to protect, trying to defend indefensible, trying to protect Fulani herdsmen who are killing your people. It's only in Biafra land that a governor will call Al-Majiri army, Janjaweed from north, from Fota Jalon, to come and kill his own people because he's trying to protect the constitution. Have you seen it? Now go to the north. None of them respect that constitution. And the constitution is written by their own people, which is Abdul Salami Abubakar, a military junta. So now, are you telling me that northerners can respect constitution when a court of competent jurisdiction pronounce somebody not guilty and the court continue holding that person, government? The Fulani federal government continue holding that person captive in the dungeon. Are you telling me they respect the court orders? And when you don't respect court orders, of course you don't respect constitution. Because the court is the, you know, they are the carrier of that very useless constitution you have. Everything court does should be from constitution. Are you telling me they respect the constitution? Are you telling me that Fulani, the North, respect constitution, that Imo people voted Emeka Ihedioha as their governor legitimately? And now, the fourth position went to Abuja. They took him to Sokoto. They razzled him with the Sultan of Sokoto in a hotel. And they brought him back take him, they took him to Federal High Court, Abuja, and the same Fulani pronouncing winner overnight without any legitimate or a document or anything that proved that this man won the election. He was not even second. He was nowhere to be found in the picture. And they pronounce him winner. And you tell me that the North respect the Constitution. Of course, they don't respect the Constitution. Is only respected here in the southern part of this very damnable zoological republic of Nigeria. But we are going to do everything humanly possible to dismantle it. It's our right to dismantle it. So, Governor Ortom, if you can be able to reason now, you reason. Benue State need ESN.